Hello and welcome back to our course on Project 2013. In this section we're going to take a look at the Quick Access Toolbar, which sits in the top left hand corner of the window. And the purpose of the Quick Access Toolbar, as its name implies, is to give us quick access to a selected small number of commands that we use frequently and really want at our fingertips so that we can execute them quickly and easily whenever we need them. Now, at any one time on the Quick Access Toolbar, you'll be able to see a selection of commands. On mine at the moment, there are actually four shown. There is Save, there is Undo, and there is Redo, and there is the command that we use, the button that we use, to switch between touch and mouse mode. Now, noticeably, the Redo command is currently grayed out. The reason it's grayed out is because redo means redo something I've just undone. I've not undone anything, so there's nothing to redo, so that command's grayed out. But in general terms, if I click on the drop down to the right hand end here, the one that has the screen tip of Customize Quick Access Toolbar, I'll see that there are about a dozen commands that I can show, and I show or hide them just by checking them. So if I wanted the quick print command here on the Quick Access Toolbar, if I just check it by clicking it, quick print now appears up there as well. Now, it's not a good idea to have loads and loads of these commands spreading across the top of the window, because you're going to clash into other things. But if you choose the ones that you think are most useful to you to have always on hand, that's the process of customizing the Quick Access Toolbar. Now, in addition to switching commands on and off, you can actually customize it in a more extensive way, and you can add commands to the Quick Access Toolbar. So let's take a look at how to do that. So to customize the Quick Access Toolbar, click on the drop down there, and then one of the commands down at the bottom says More Commands. Click on that, and that takes us into another page of the project options, the page that's called Quick Access Toolbar. Now, on that page there is a list initially of the popular commands within Project 2013. There may be about 50 of those commands. But if I use the drop down at the top here, you'll see that if I looked at all commands, so select that instead, you'll see that in Project 2013 overall there are literally hundreds of commands, and I could add any of those to the Quick Access Toolbar. Now, I'm not going to add some sort of vaguely esoteric command. Let's go back to the popular ones. Let's choose, say, the copy command. If I select copy there and click on add, the button in the middle, the copy command will be added to the Quick Access Toolbar. If I then click on OK, you can now see up there, there is a copy command on the Quick Access Toolbar. So it's as easy as that to customize what's shown. What sometimes happens if you're doing a particular job in Project 2013 is that you find you have something repetitive to do. I mentioned earlier on that you might create your own tab and your own group and put your own commands in it. Well, another good option is being able to add one or two commands to the Quick Access Toolbar while you're doing perhaps a particular job, and then you can remove them again. To remove a command from the Quick Access Toolbar, click on the drop down again, go into More Commands again, choose the one you want to remove, in this case copy, so I select copy on the right, and then the other button in the middle is remove. Click on OK, and that copy command is no longer included in the Quick Access Toolbar. Now, there's one other thing you can do with the Quick Access Toolbar, and that is if you're doing a repetitive, perhaps complicated, or perhaps even slightly boring job, then you can actually show the Quick Access Toolbar below the ribbon. Click on the drop down again, choose the very bottom command, Show Below the Ribbon. It appears down there. The reason sometimes that people like that is that when you're working within the main area, say you're working on a Gantt chart here, you don't have to stretch across the ribbon to find the command that you want, possibly hit something on the ribbon on the way. You've got the Quick Access Toolbar right next to the area you're working in. To put that back where it was, it's pretty straightforward. Just click on Show Above the Ribbon again. So I'm going to show this back above the ribbon. And that's really it on the Quick Access Toolbar. Pretty straightforward. In the next section, we're going to look at mini toolbars. So please join me for that.
Hi everyone, Simon here from Simon Says It. Thanks for watching this video. If this is your first time here, I'd love for you to subscribe. Every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, new videos are uploaded to the Simon Says It channel here on YouTube. Just click on the subscribe button right over there. If you're interested in taking your Microsoft Project 2013 training to the next level, you can get 19 hours of Project 2013 training offered by Simon Says It. Just check out the About section below this video with more details. We'll see you next week with additional videos.